So here with Gerrald Emeagawli for the Footie Show, it's a Euro special, and we're both on the pier, weren't we? Didn't quite make it to Wembley, but we got to the end of the pier to
indeed.
Watch. So it's England versus Croatia. Tell us all about it. 1-0 victory to England. Hot day. An okay game. Wasn't brilliant, was it?
It was an okay game. It didn't start well. But England were the team that were definitely trying to make most of the game from the beginning. And you could see the way they were passing the ball about. Croatia are a tough team, but they weren't really playing the way we know Croatia to play. I mean, Luka Modric is 35 years old now, and you have other players sort of reaching to the end of their careers in the team. They need sort of a young, fresh generation that's going to come through and sort of be that new face of Croatia. Whereas England already has that in the young players.
Yeah.
And Sterling proving that on the day, and Kevin Phillips also playing really well. It shows even with the young manager they have in Southgate, he sort of puts his trust in these young players even more.
Yeah. And what about the goal? I mean, Sterling, it was a decent goal from Raheem Sterling. After we missed a few, hit the post, and obviously Kane afterwards could have made it 2, miss a sitter as well.
From Kane, I was a bit disappointed. A player of his stature should be playing and scoring goals, you know, putting away goals like that easily. But we saw it was the younger players again, Foden, Sterling, and Calvin Phillips, like I say, even Declan Rice also. These people seem to be more up for it than Kane was, and he just seemed like he was dragging his feet across the park. And it was no surprise to see him get substituted later on and see Bellingham come on for his first international game.